First, we should introduce the purpose behind this video. Primarily, it's a method of continuing on documenting how I'm fixing the Ford Probe project, but alternately, it's to introduce the CAD development unit in my classroom. Because of COVID-19, we can't use shared desktops, and so we have to use an online platform to figure out the CAD drawing software, and so we've chosen Onshape, something that is very similar to things that we've used in the classroom. We use primarily Autodesk Inventor in the classroom, and so I wanted to show the extent of what we could achieve with a CAD software suite online and introduce the method that way. So I have this seatbelt buckle covering that is broken, obviously. This was broken when I got the vehicle, but then one hot day it just snapped apart, and so I am making a new bottom piece for the time being to introduce this subject so that I can have snaps there and there. So we will go further and we will introduce observations about this, and then I will sort of give a commentary while I am drawing this. So some stray observations that we need to make. This seatbelt cover casing is not a parallel rectangular box. There's a slight slant to it coming up. At the same time, we have curved edges. So we're going to do a couple of assumptions. We are going to assume angle based on this distance and this distance, and we are going to assume curvature based on a tangent sticking up out of our seatbelt case covering. Some more observations that we can make is part number in the middle there. We have part number, and then we have a number off to the side. Now, we can also see push pins in here. That's what those circular pieces are in the geometry. Those are push pins off of an injection molded piece, and so we can assume that this number 2 here stands for the second cavity in this part. We don't know if it's a 4 cavity or a 2 cavity, or if it's some weird odd number cavitation other than 1, but we do know that it is at least 2 cavities. That's not super important for what we're going to be doing, but it is an observation that we can make just in case this video does get used for any kind of manufacturing classroom. Some more observations that we need to make is chamfer and locationary snap and locationary position features. We have basically T's in all 3 sections on both sides. At the same time, we have positional features at the bottom of both pieces. And the cool part about this is that they are different sizes based on the right side or the left side. So looking at it this way, the left side is taller than the right side, and that is so that you can't fit this piece on the wrong way. Okay, it's sort of a mini pokey yoke. So with that, we will get started on drawing this. Where this video starts out, I have placed 4 points and a line. I'm starting to address the curvature of the buckle cover profile. I don't want to give a guess measurement for the bottom since I'm hitting the end of a curve feature, but I can get the bottom point midway, set an arc between the top point and the line, then use a coincident constraint to make sure it hits all the measured points. You'll notice that I'm using a lot of vocabulary the beginner will not understand, and that's okay. I'm also speaking quickly so that I can just set the video to 8 times the speed and give commentary for it. You don't have to follow along. I'm not going to give measurements, I'm just introducing the kinds of things CAD software can do. Now I'm doing 2 extrusions. The first is an add extrude where I'm adding material, then a cut extrude where I'm taking that material away. This will give me the basic form and a plane whereby I can draw the rest of the features from it. I'll add some fillets to clean it up. Then I'm going to make the 2 main ribs. I need an outer bound, so that's why I'm drawing those curves again. Then I'm drawing 4 lines, measuring them from each other, and then from the top, then extruding them. Off camera, I did the further extrude then cut so that I can set the angle I was talking about at the beginning of the video. There's a divot in the ribs where seatbelt internal mechanisms need to pass freely without any interference, so I'll cut extrude a curve based on a circle. Next is the bottom boundary of sorts, which acts as a safety just in case the positional rectangles break, or so that the cover doesn't pull off the seatbelt assembly. After that, it's just a matter of playing with fillets. Off camera, I made those positional rectangles that I was talking about. Again, the left one was taller than the right. I also am going to do a draft angle on them. This one is more severe than an injection molded draft of 1 or 2 degrees, so I'm going to assume this is for ease of assembly. The final three features are T-shapes. The first two pairs are at an angle with vertical, trying to follow the arc of the side curve, so I take a measurement at the top and the bottom. I also need to measure to the middle so that they are symmetrical. Even for features like this, getting all of the measurements you can is going to help you. You can't get by with just the thickness of the T-form. For both of these next two T-shapes, I need to add the snap feature, the piece that was broken from the bottom. To get these measurements, I measured the other half of the buckle cover to get a minimum chamfer angle, height, and depth. You notice from there that I also removed the unnecessary back sides of those T-shapes with a chamfer. Just like Inventor, you can check other features for measurements and copy them to your next feature. I did this to relearn what the snap chamfer would be. The final T-shape is another positional form. This time though, it's positioning with the other half of the buckle cover. There's a recessed form where the shape just slides directly into it. You'll notice that I did a copy and paste instead of just drawing the next one. This makes things a whole lot easier. After that final extrude, and after some more chamfers, it's all done. I'm missing some features at the top here, because I think I'm missing another piece. And so until I, you know, find that piece and figure out what these intended ribs are supposed to do, I don't want to fake design them just for the intent of this video. Again, this was supposed to provide you with an introduction to the sorts of things that you can do with CAD software and the things that you can do with an online software. It's a seemingly very robust system. Saves automatically and you get really all the basic functions that any sort of desktop suite can give you. Thanks for watching. If you're one of my student viewers, then there's some more videos that you need to watch. You're not gonna make anything as complex as this. We're gonna be looking towards making a birdhouse or a toolbox, something that you can easily make in the introductory level of Woodshop. If you're one of my subscriber viewers, then I appreciate your viewership as well. Keep following along. I'm sure there will be plenty more content as we continue along, starting even the school year. Thanks. See you next time.